Hello learners, welcome to the NIOS studios. I'm Binita Sen. I'm a children's author and storyteller. Before this, we have discussed some methods by which you can develop language in children. Now, this time in the second part, we will go further to see how we can use creative methods to develop language. Now, we will first look at issues like repetition and reiteration. Repetition and reiteration are two great tools to learn a language. Let us say a forward-backward movement like simple chart of days of the week. So you say, today is Tuesday, yesterday was Monday, tomorrow will be Wednesday. The child gets three facts there and learns also not just the days of the week but also these new sentences. Involve the child. Children have different abilities, so start simple. String simple sentences, perhaps play a game. Start with yourself. Let's play a game, you say, and the child is at ease because you've not said this is a lesson. You say, my name is Anita. What is your name? Say it with a smile. Repeat next day for reiteration or include the surname if you feel that the child has learnt the first day's lesson well. The second day you could say, let's play the same game today and my name is Anita Anand. What is your name? This game is best played in a group because then you can instruct the children to look to their right or the left and pass the question around. Now, when you address a child by name, you make that effort to forge a personal bond. So, instead of saying, where do you live? If you can say, where do you live, Pia? The child will be more comfortable. These are little tips and tricks which we hope will work for you. I, me and myself are three topics which most of us love to talk about. Children, of course, they love to talk about themselves. Topics, therefore, in that I, me and myself category would be parts of my body and the functions like I hear with my ears or a routine. I ate dalia for breakfast. What did you eat, Rohan? Or colors. You show them a color band and then you say, my favorite color is red. Which is your favorite color, Rohan? Or what about animals? These are issues that are close to a child's heart, more or less. My favorite animal is the rabbit. Do you have a favorite animal? Which is yours? Songs are great teachers of language. Different sounds increase the vocabulary of a child. Discriminate between similar sounding words also. Now, watch me carefully. There is this little song we have sung for generations and it goes something like, oh Chester, have you heard of Harry? Just come back from the army. I hear he knows how to wear a rose. Hip, hip, hooray for the army. Now, it's a song that has stuck with us most of our lives. But it's a song that has taught us to string words together, to understand puns or a play on words, and so many other issues. Now, so you can end a song that is repeated every day for about a week. Don't panic if all the children don't get to understand the song at one go. Keep repeating. Like, say, when the children are about to leave the room, you sing that song. Remember? Bits of paper, lying on the ground, lying on the ground, makes the place untidy. Pick them up, pick them up. How many sentences, emotions, everything has gone into this little song. It's a simple song like these little rhymes most children sing. And this is a great way to teach language. Child is like a sponge. Verbal language and the skills needed for verbal language are learned from listening to words that are floating around in the environment. It is difficult to devote time to speak to a child and play rhymes. If it is difficult to devote time to speak to a child, play rhymes. They can be nursery rhymes, they can be rhymes. You have made anything that has a sing-song cadence to it and anything that a child's attention will go to. Repeat the rhymes. We learned about stars and that they twinkle. Twinkle is not an easy word, but we learnt it very young from that rhyme. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Now, there are two difficult words in there, twinkle and wonder. Listening and learning. Speaking regularly also improves listening skills so that a child can pick up new words from the larger environment. Dramatization or role play can bring out even a shy child. Now, dramatization would mean I pretend to be the king of the world. Even if I am a shy person, if I'm given a role play, I am more likely to come out of my shell because I'm speaking the lines of a character, and that's how I learn new words. Soft toys and puppets help a child to come out of the shell and speak, and that is why we've got all these lined up. Which child can resist when you say, and what did the cat say? Meow. So this is the magic of props. Storytelling encourages a child to use words. A child may need some prompting to retell a tale or to create a new story. Use story mats or cards. Flashcards, of course, we use. We aim to encourage the child to use new words. It's a lifelong journey. It doesn't end with childhood. We are constantly, you and I, are constantly trying to learn new words in different languages. There will be speed breakers on the way. You will falter. You will use the wrong word perhaps. But ultimately, through all the tools that we have mentioned till now, you will get there. The aim is not to stop, but to take it easy over each bump on the way and keep going. Remember, each child is different just as each adult is different, each tree is different, each of these toys is different. Some children will take a little more time than others. Have patience, respect individuality, and you'll see the magic. The words come tumbling out. So learners, in this video, we have learnt some of the ways by which we can increase the vocabulary of a child. There are more ways, but we will discuss that in another video. Thank you for being with us on this journey and see you on the other side. Thank you.